It's the place to be. And Fox 8 brings you all the fun and excitement live from the Louisiana Superdome. It's Endymion 2003 with your hosts, John Snell and Nancy Parker.
Good evening. I'd say we timed it out fairly well because as we hit the 9:30 hour here, or half hour, Endymion, literally 7 or 8 minutes ago, rolled into the dome with, that great entrance it always makes.
Yeah, it's hard to describe the feeling in here. Everyone is so excited. They're already going up to the balconies, waiting for those precious throws from the biggest crew of Carnival. Let's go down on the floor to Joe Trahan and Claudia Coffey. What's it like down there, guys?
Well, you guys, we're at a fever pitch already down here on the floor. The New Orleans police have come through. The Shriners have come through. And so this crowd is ready to see some floats roll through. I'm here with Claudia Coffey. You look lovely. That's a beautiful gown tonight, Claudia. Look at this.
You sound like Joan Rivers.
It's like emerald green.
Thank Carol Clark for this one. We are like Joan and Melissa down here, aren't we?
That's right.
What are you wearing?
That's right. We'll be critiquing some folks' dress. We'll talk about Cooling the Gang, find out what their favorite songs are.
Getting big, big bags of beats.
They're already
too.
Coming in. Wonderful. I guarantee you I will have people dancing on command. It'll be a lot of fun down here on the floor. But we're not alone this year on the floor.
No, we're not. We have Nichelle Turner at the other end of the reviewing stand. She's going to catch a lot of people as they come in. Nichelle, how does it look from your end?
It's great, guys. You know, they split us up for a reason because I'm going to be looking hard for everybody that's in the crowd. This is going to be such a fun night. I've actually got 3 strands of beads already, but the Shriners were a little stingy with the beads. I was trying to get them to throw to me. I am so excited about Endymion. This crowd is excited, too. I can't believe 12,000 people are inside the dome. It's going to be so much fun. John and Nancy, I have the first vantage point, but you guys seem to have the best seat in the house, so I'm going to send it back to you.
Yeah, you better believe we have the best seat in the house, and we also have like a preview of some of the throws we're going to get. These things are really coveted. This is the Golden Boy throw.
The Golden Boy throw?
Yeah, and it's a throw on the Prince float, and it actually blinks, as you can see. Wait a minute. Yeah, it's doing it.
You can see that?
I don't know. Can you see it blink? But anyway,
there's a little light in here, so maybe not.
These are like gold, so these are very precious. John, the people here tonight, a lot of people say it's not as many people on the floor tonight, but it looks about the same as last year.
All I know is that it's about 12,000 to 14,000 people. Something that started as just the small little neighborhood mid-city parade, and it's grown into Carnival's biggest show.
Unbelievable.
I think Bob Breck is enjoying himself tonight.
You know, when Ed Muniz had the idea for this, he actually almost named this crew Bacchus, believe it or not. But eventually, Bacchus was taken. But he came up with Bacchus first, and then he said, no, Endymion is pretty good. He went to the racetrack, and the horse that he had put money on won, and the name of the horse was Endymion. So he knew that he was going to be a winner from here on out.
The name's been lucky for him in a variety of ways. You know, there's been so much discussion about this new route because of the construction for the Canal Streetcar Line at Orleans and down to Canal, and the fact that Endymion has always rolled that way, with the exception of the year of the police strike. Nobody really knows how this is going to work out. And at farther down the parade route at the House of Roll, where our other location is, float number 22 at last report, which is Captain Eddie's SS Endymion, had not made it there. It's that huge, largest crew in Carnival, 200 riders. They did a little test drive, I understand, on St. Charles Avenue the other night, and it had just a little bit of trouble. So they really weren't sure, A, how these huge floats would manage, and B, more importantly, they didn't have really the foggiest idea what time they'd get here tonight, but so far it's worked out pretty well as we see the Marine Band parading in.
This is just the prelude to what is going to be an awesome night.
You know, it's amazing when there is so much noise in here when those police cars come through that we showed you 10 minutes ago, and yet you can still hear the roar of the crowd over all of those sirens. You can't hardly hear yourself think, but you can hear that.
And this is what people wait for Carnival. Rex has the pageantry. Zulu has its quirkiness and its tradition. But this is a parade that people stand up, take note. We have bands from all over the country. I think maybe 10 states are here in the Dome tonight performing for this. People come from miles around. Celebrities show up for Endymion. And it's something that you can tell your kids about when you're old.
And, of course, the Grand Marshal this year is Aaron Carter, the brother of the Backstreet Boy, Nick Carter, who I must confess, you know, I've told that to so many people. Oh, who's that? Nobody, you know, adults, the 40 and 35 on up crowd don't know. All I know is I have three nieces ages 6, 11, and 13, and they are thrilled beyond expression that I will be in the same room tonight as Aaron Carter. I've explained to them that it's the world's largest room, so it's not that big a deal. But
yeah, I think the Mary-Kate and Ashley crowd love Aaron Carter. He's only 15 years old. But he's had a long career. He started singing at 10.
And I don't know if you'll listen in or not, we're going to see if the microphone catches the national anthem, which they are about to play here. Or did I jump the gun on the national anthem?
I think you jumped the gun. They're going to introduce the theme of this wonderful night, New Orleans A to Z.
Neutral grounds and the fairgrounds. Muffalatas and Kings. And this year, Endymion and the Garden District. Also, there are fond memories of other people and places that just ain't there no more. Pontchartrain Beach and Lake.
They look no worse for the wear after this, 6 or 8 mile trip tonight, the longest trip that anybody will make during Mardi Gras.
Unbelievable. And one interesting fact about Endymion is that when the first floats actually entered the dome, there's still 5 miles worth of parade behind it. That's how long this parade is.
Let's find out how things are going along the parade route. Jeff Baskin is there.
And it's been about 1 hour between floats number 20 and 21. Float 21 has just passed. In the meantime, the natives and tourists alike became rather restless. We actually lost a good deal of the crowd on St. Charles Avenue in front of the House of Brohl. You can see that a lot of the ladders are actually gone. Some of the people now coming back because the floats are on their way once again. We just had float number 21, Oaks and Oysters, go on by, and we still have 7 more floats after that. Now, there have been some problems with the floats getting stuck, especially the last few floats. That includes the Endymion signature float, the mega float, the SS Endymion. It's a big float, and that could be part of the reason that they had some trouble with getting that float stuck. Those floats are big, and sometimes they do have a little bit of trouble navigating those turns. And we saw about an hour break, and we did lose a lot of the crowd. Again, it looks like Endymion is back underway on the traditional uptown route for the first time, and its first time off the mid-city route since 1979, when it was in Kenner due to a police strike in New Orleans. Well, it looks like the revelers are now coming back to St. Charles Avenue as Endymion continues. But again, now it looks like maybe there's another break between floats number 21 and 22, which is the SS Endymion. So that one float that went by could just be a temporary indication that the parade's underway. No word on the status of the other float. So we'll be standing here by, waiting for the rest of the floats as they come by in front of the House of Brohl on St. Charles Avenue. Back to you.
All right, thanks so much, Jeff. The captain's float has just rolled in, and I hear a second line, baby. Ed Muniz is dressed as Louis Philippe, Duke of Orleans, for whom our wonderful city was named. And you see his tunic is red and blue velvet, sort of reminiscent of those Spanish and French who ran this city a long time ago.
You know, you always do so much better a job describing the appliques and
you
all
like
the,
that?
Yeah, I'm not there. I don't want to be chauvinistic, but
Let me handle that.
It's funny. It always amazes me when you look at the captain's float, because you know the captain's float for so many crews is the captain and a couple of his aides. And, you know, a duke, and this thing is a regular Mardi Gras float.
Yeah, it's 80 riders. And that was not gunfire. That was a cannon, I think, of some kind. 80 riders on this float, and this is nothing compared to the other ones you'll see. But there's also room for a band on this float, which is really neat.
Stylized medieval military commander's band.
I think they will be very pleased when they stop and think about this, at least with the early part here, because the thought, the hope was that they would roll in maybe sometime after 9 o'clock, but they really didn't have any way of knowing, and I'm sure we'll keep you posted throughout the night to try to let you know that little bit of suspense of Captain Eddie's SS Endymion, the big float, which apparently is stuck somewhere along the way. They said their plan was, you know, it's one of those tandem floats of about three pieces. The plan was not to take it apart. The plan was to leave it up to the truck driver to find a way to navigate.
And hopefully all navigation is clear, because got a lot of people waiting.
You know, those guys on stilts are about, if you see them kind of in the middle of the picture there, are up about 14 feet up. I mean, they're almost two stories.
Yeah, there are a couple of guys from Florida who've made a living traveling around, walking on stilts.
That's not bad, a bad job if you can get it done.
I think there's a little bit of talent involved in that. Well, the party, as you see, is just getting rolling. We've got much more of it to come, and we'll continue our coverage of Endymion 2003 in a moment.
Fox 8 coverage of Endymion 2003 is brought to you in part by Antoine's Famous Cakes and Pastries. Welcome back to Endymion 2003, live on Fox 8. Here's John Snell and Nancy Parker.
Welcome back to Endymion 2003, and we are getting pelted at times up here. This is really fun, John.
Yeah, we're up in the nosebleed section almost.
We are.
And they're hitting us.
Throw me something, mister.
I'm not sure that voice is going to get you much tonight, okay? Let's find out how things are going down there, how much they're throwing. Claudia Coffey's in the midst of it.
Down here, John. It's so much fun. And you get hammered so much when you're right here by the reviewing stand. Let me show you something. This is the way to do carnival. This is a cage that has been crafted at a completely enclosed area. This is Ed Muniz's mother. Hi, Mamie. Yay. And so she is such a diehard Mardi Gras fan. But she's like, look, I'm not coming unless you protect me, because I'm going to get hit by so many bees. And this is Gilda here. Gilda's always helping Mamie out a lot. Tell me why she wanted to have this.
Well, it was always every year that her and her son, when her father, his dad, organized this parade. And it started out with him and his father. And she's just been a parade goer ever since. She also loves the St. Patrick's Parade, where she normally would ride. If she's able and up again, she'll be at St. Patrick's Parade.
So does she take this with her?
Huh?
Does she take this with her for the St. Patrick's Day Parade as well?
Oh, yeah. If she's fine for St. Patrick's, she will be at St. Patrick's Parade. This is a lady that loves carnival. And her son made sure. She has a beautiful family. I tell you, she really does.
I don't know. I may be snuggling in there with her in a little bit, just because it's going to get so crazy out here.
You can snuggle in with us. We are protected. Trust me, we are protected.
Oh, you all have a wonderful time. Happy Mardi Gras to you. Thank you, Mamie. Wave one more time. You just saw your son. Yay! That's the way to do it. If you guys snuggle in here too, we'll save a little bit of room for you. Back to you guys.
All right. Thanks, Claudia. I think they're about to do the national anthem now. So let's listen.
Obviously, that's not the new
national
anthem. So I think they got that done during the interview with Mimi. You know, that little cage there could catch on.
During the interview with Mimi. And, you know, while Mimi was talking or watching the parade, we were getting just pelted. And now there's confetti falling all over the dome. It's sort of like a winter wonderland in here. And I see another float entering.
Preceded by the flambeau. I think they have 14 flambeau carriers in Endymion. You know, it's really, a lot of people sort of miss the traditional flambeau because this one's the, I think, propane-powered ones.
A much safer one.
A much safer one. They're not dripping gas and flame onto the street. But those guys line up. That's a choice little job to get to do that.
Yeah, and it's one of those things, as you said, that's reminiscent of the very first Mardi Gras in the late 1800s.
True, lighted as they were.
And those are the golden boys. You remember the beads I showed you? Those are the big version of the beads.
I didn't see any string. You know, the flambeau almost went by the wayside about 15 years ago because insurance companies got wind of what was happening. They said, you're doing what?
Yes.
With how many thousands of people around? That's crazy. So they had to find a way and negotiate with the insurance companies because of the reality of lawsuits and the reality of cost, and found a way to keep that tradition alive.
And you remember, I told you that paper was falling as well. That's not a good thing.
You know, it's awfully filthy down there right now, and we're just getting going. Look at the litter.
Let's go to Michelle Turner on the floor.
That's how you do it. It is getting kind of filled down here. I have my first Mardi Gras injury. You guys are getting pelted up there. I just absolutely got hammered by about 50 beads, hot beads. They hurt so bad. I'm on the celebrity watch tonight, and look who I found. The biggest celebrities in New Orleans, your weather authority, Bob Breck and Mrs. Bob Breck. How are you guys doing tonight?
Great.
You all look wonderful.
Terrific time.
Oh, and Bob, you look all right.
Did you say you're coming to me during a lull in the parade, or you said you're coming to me because John Snell is dull?
Let's see.
Just kidding. Just kidding.
Bob's having a little fun tonight, everybody. You know, this is such a fun party. It's my first Endymion, so I'm just amazed, but this is just such a great party.
Did John say it did not rain? If he hasn't said that yet, he should, because he knows that on Tuesday night, I told Endymion, no rain!
Did John doubt you? He doubted the weather authority?
Shame on him. He knows better. Goodness, Nancy's there to keep him in tow.
Exactly. You guys have a good time. You look wonderful. All right. You guys, like we said, it's going to be a fun night tonight. I got Mr. and Mrs. Bob Breck here with me. I'm still on the celebrity patrol. I saw Harry Lee somewhere, so I'm going to look out for him and see if I can find him. He's been cracking jokes all night, so he'll be a lot of fun. We'll try to talk to him in a little bit. But I'll send it back up to you guys. I see
all right.
You way, way up there.
All right, Michelle, thanks. And the neat thing about this parade this year is Harry Lee is going to be honored on a float. Mayor Ray Nagin is going to be honored on a float. Irma Thomas is honored on a float. So it'll be nice to see tributes to them. And like I said, it's all about New Orleans.
It really is a terrific theme, New Orleans from A to Z. And by the way, as far as the B's go in the alphabet, I never doubted you, Bob. Not for an instant. It did rain on me, though, for about a minute today.
Yeah.
Just out of nowhere. One of the great highlights of Carnival, the St. Aug Marching 100. We'll try to listen in to them as they get a little closer to our microphone. They're doing pretty good after this long, long trip tonight. I wonder how many miles they run or walk during the course of all of Carnival. It's got to be 30, 40, 50 miles.
And they're used to it. I mean, these folks go all the way to the Rose Bowl and parade. So they're used to walking and sounding terrific, and everybody wants them. So Marching 100. Let's go down now to Claudia Coffey, talking to a man who makes a lot of this possible tonight. Claudia?
You must have a headache by now. You do so much stuff around here. Blame her.
It's a lot of fun. There's no headache at all.
And you know what? I've had to interview you. I've had the pleasure of interviewing you the last 3 years that I've been here, and you always seem like you're having a great time.
You know what? I've been doing it over 50 years now, and today it isn't any more fun. I won't do it anymore.
Any problems along the parade route tonight that you're hearing about?
No, little where the floats came up the wharf, it was a lot lower. So much pressure broke some of the wells, but we actually were able to effect a quick cure. We fixed it, but it was a job for a while. But it got underway.
Such a challenge, Endymion on the St. Charles route, huh? How nice was that?
I never thought I'd see the day.
Well, what are you looking forward to tonight? How do you make this fun for Blaine Kern? How does it get much more fun?
I can't hear you even.
Hard to believe. How does it get much more fun for you? What are you looking for?
Well, okay. Wow.
We have the band right up in our faces right now. How about this? Enjoy the band this way. Tell you what, we're gonna toss it back to John and Nancy from here. Thank you so much, Blaine Kern.
All right, thanks, Claudia. Let's listen in, but of course, on cue, the marching 100 stop.
That's the way it works. We are seeing now, coming into the Superdome, the St. Mary's Academy marching band and dance team. And in just a moment, we will have Aaron Carter, who, as you said, your nieces are in love with.
He's right behind the St. Mary's band, as a matter of fact. What some of these kids think when they walk into the Superdome, especially the out-of-town bands, that are in any Mardi Gras parade, because they bring bands in from virtually every state in America for, you know, some parade somewhere, and just to walk and see the crowds and to see, you know, 20 or 30 or 40 people deep, it's got to be awesome.
Well, and the fact that the floats, and as large as they are, they comfortably fit in the Superdome. They must be going, wow, I can't wait to tell my mom about this. Let's go down to Joe Trahan on the floor.
Yeah, you guys, speaking of all these fans who have gathered here, we've got some of them amongst us. I know Michelle is on the Celebrity Watch. I'm just, you know, Joe Common Man. I'm with the common people hanging out 50, 60 deep here, having a good time. You'll be our spokesman, sir. What's your name and where you're from?
Randy Ransom from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. And I wanted to say I'm so proud to be here tonight and see the military represented, because they are our lifeblood in our country, and I thank God for our military. Amen.
Thanks for the patriotic thoughts on this day. I also saw this. As you guys know, I'm a sports anchor. Your team has had some very good moments in this building. I was in here for a national championship, so you should have more fun than everybody else. We got people from all over the place. Ma'am, your name and where you're from?
I'm Valerie, Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Now, how'd you find out about Mardi Gras in Minneapolis, and why'd you decide to come?
My very special someone is on a float.
Nice, nice, very good. Well, you guys, are y'all having fun? Are y'all having fun over here? All right, great. Y'all don't look like you're having fun. They're not even warmed up yet, you guys. I'll get them going. Back to you for now, though.
All right, thanks, Joe. There he is, Aaron Carter, the Prince of Teen Pop, they call him. The young singer and actor riding as sort of the new Prince of Endymion, the Grand Marshal of Endymion 2003.
Came to New Orleans with his family on an RV. He's only 15 years old, so he travels with his mom and dad. And so the RV, I think, was actually in the parade. He has a twin sister. And, of course, Nick Carter is his brother of the Backstreet Boys. You know what? I need a brother that's a Backstreet Boy. My life would be so much easier.
You need a brother who's a multimillionaire at age 15. That's what you need. They are throwing, he is throwing a special flashing beads necklace of the Prince
the one
Aaron
that
Carter.
I showed you.
But they've got another one. I think they've got a special one for him that they've done.
Oh, okay.
This kid has sold something like 10 million records.
I mean, he is everywhere. He's in Spain, Denmark, Canada, Norway, Taiwan. Everybody loves Aaron Carter. And now I see why. He's cute. He's a cute kid. All right. We'll be back with much more of Endymion 2003 in a moment.
Now, back with more of Endymion 2003 on Fox 8, live tonight from the Louisiana Superdome. Here's John Snell and Nancy Parker.
The co-grand marshal,
12,000 people in the Superdome, as you see Aaron Carter's float making its way out, because at the beginning here, they have to actually take the floats out. Eventually, they start stacking them up one after the other, and I'm sorry, that's Captain Edmunez's float as it leaves. Eventually, they just sort of park them after one another, but it's such a big parade that even in the Superdome, with this little makeshift roadway they've made, they don't have room for all of the floats.
We're looking at the McDonough 35 marching band. Now, that guy looks tired.
She doesn't.
No, she's really into this carnival thing. In a few moments, we should be seeing Pete Fountain come in, and everyone knows Pete Fountain. I mean, he's a New Orleans legend. And he's co-grand marshal of Endymion this year.
Well, this is what it's all about, to bring it into the Superdome. I think some of the revelers there look like they're a little worse for the wear. It's just getting going.
Let's go to Joe Trahan, who's right on the floor in the thick of things.
Aaron, how's your ride been so far, bud?
Real good, man. But it was long. My hands are hurting.
That's right. Was it a good workout for you?
Oh yeah, definitely. I'm gonna be bigger.
You're gonna be pumped?
Actually, what you expected though.
Well, I got a lot of threats and stuff from guys. A lot of people threw beads at me and stuff. But, you know, that was just the guys, just jealous guys. But it was really fun. I had a good time. It was really fun.
You have done so much already at such a young age. What else are you going to do? Well, I mean, come on, you're 15. How did you get in here? You have to be 18 to get in.
I'm going to do everything I can until I can't do it no more, you know?
You're only 15. Did you see some things tonight that a 15-year-old should not have seen? You can be honest here.
Well, yes. And no, but it was a good thing.
All right, good. You got a roll, bud. Thanks so much for talking with us. That's Aaron Carter, tonight's Celebrity Grand Marshal. John, Nancy, back to you.
He's 15. 15, and he's done all that in his life.
That's true. You know, he's one of the youngest people in the building. He might be the youngest person in the building, unless, you know, somebody snuck someone in.
Oh, look, I see another float coming in, and I think it's Pete Fountain.
Pete Fountain, as you said, the co-grand marshal of Endymion, the jazz legend. And on this float, actually, they've got several sports heroes from New Orleans, too. Deuce McAllister, Michael Lewis, and Baron Davis, the New Orleans Hornet, are all on this float as well.
Baron Davis must feel like he's in the land of Oz. He's probably saying, what is this about? I'm so glad I moved here. But I guess it's lucky, but it's not lucky. He has a torn ACL in his knee, and that's the only reason that he's here tonight, because the Hornets are actually playing tonight. So he gets to ride an Endymion while his friends sweat it out on the court.
Well, we'll get him back. Pete looks like royalty up there. Of course, he's accustomed to Mardi Gras with his half fast, careful how you say that, marching club.
Yeah.
And as McDonough 35 makes its way out, here comes Pete.
I think I see, is that Michael Lewis tossing on the side there?
I think that's Michael Lewis tossing on the side, number 84. A couple years ago, a beer delivery guy.
Unbelievable. He's loving this. I mean, he has come so far.
You know, he's got a pretty good arm for a guy who plays wide receiver and
kick
returner.
Michael Lewis,
2,100 yards last season in punt return, almost breaking the record, 54 yards from breaking the
did
NFL
you know
record.
That off the top of your head?
Sure, I can.
I thought maybe somebody fed that to you. Do you suppose Pete thinks anybody can hear him?
Well, I think he's just faking it right now.
But 72 years old, Pete found just a New Orleans treasure.
I cannot believe that he's 72. He, I think being involved and running the half-fast marching club, he has his own club in the Hilton Hotel. And everyone remembers the Basin Street Six in the 1950s. Lawrence Welk Show. Pete Fountain has done it all.
We see Pete Fountain, of course, every Mardi Gras, makes his way from uptown and then down Bourbon Street. Usually get, like clockwork, usually gets there maybe about 11 o'clock. And has a crew of 30 or 50 people with him who make that
walking.
Trip. Yes.
And we there's Deuce McAllister.
Deuce and Michael having made the Pro Bowl.
The deuce is loose.
For the New Orleans Saints.
Sort of.
And of course for themselves.
Dome looks a little different, probably, to Deuce McAllister tonight than his
high
normal conditions.
Marching band entering the Superdome.
And he's probably thinking to himself, I ran all that way.
Hey, Greg, throw me something. Now, good that arm.
I think Deuce is going at it just a little more slowly than Michael. Michael Lewis was just unloading it.
Right.
Deuce his arm will be sore at the end of the day. Deuce is kind of pacing himself because, you know, this party will go on, I think, until about 5 in the morning before they finally, you know, close it down. And I think the only reason the party ends is the music stops. Otherwise, I guess it would be sunrise.
As you can see, a whole band on this float, along with Deuce and Michael and Pete Fountain.
Houston, Texas, the Forest Brook Senior High School.
If you want a Mardi Gras marathon experience, there are those people who do this parade tonight and this ball, and then they go to the Bacchus extravaganza tomorrow in the convention center, which is a little bit of a different experience, but very similar to this in some ways, and they'll do that till the wee hours of the morning. And then, I don't know how they make it through Lundi Gras, but it happens.
Well, we were told there were a couple of slow-ups on the route. We're going to go to Jeff Baskin and check and see what's going on out there, Jeff.
Well, Nancy, finally, a float is coming by. Actually, the parade started over 4 hours ago at the House of Brohl in St. Charles Avenue, but we've had, in the last 2 hours, only two floats go by, and that's been about it. And now, finally, we have another float, float number 23, just about making it here in front of the House of Brohl. Of course, a lot of people just got frustrated with the big wait and left. Lots of big gaps. This is not even close to the kind of crowd we had earlier, just a couple of hours ago, when the parade was in its early stages. And here is float number 23, warehouses to the west end. And you can see it looks like a double float here. And it's slowly making its way in front of the House of Brohl. And the people who stuck it out, waiting for the rest of the parade to come by, look awfully happy that their efforts became fruitful and they're getting to see the rest of the parade. There have been a couple of breakdowns with the last few floats. That's what has been causing all the delays. Float number 27 broke down twice. There was a problem with one of the floats in front of that as well, but it looks like things are starting back up again as floats now returning in front of the House of Brohl on St. Charles Avenue. Again, after this, we're looking at about 5 more floats, and then we should be looking at the end of this parade. But it's already been going on for a while now, 4 hours long. I'm looking to the back of this float, and it looks like there are more floats following this float. So we could be wrapping it up rather shortly here in front of the House of Brohl, most likely within the next half hour, 45 minutes, if indeed all the other floats that had problems earlier are now moving once again. floats were likely just waiting for each other to work again and to be repaired, so that you didn't just have one float and then a big break and then another float. That's what we saw earlier with SS Endymion. There were no floats before within half an hour of that float passing. But again, looks like things wrapping up now in front of the House of Brawl. John and Nancy?
Jeff, I know it's noisy there. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, John.
I know you said that number 23 was passing. Number 22 is the big super float, the Captain Eddie's SS Endymion. Have you seen any sign of that? I wasn't sure what you were saying.
Well, yes, John, the SS Endymion did pass.
Okay.
That was about at least half an hour ago. There was a big gap in front of the SS Endymion as well. So within about an hour period, that was the only float to pass in front of us, John.
All right, so we're seeing gaps on both sides then of that. So apparently, as Blaine Curtin was talking about, some wheel problems and the sorts of things that they sort of experience every year, but apparently multiple problems and multiple floats having problems tonight. Representing Jackson Square. All right, Jeff Baskin, thanks so much, live uptown.
We're looking now at the Endymion Maids representing the Bucare and Jackson Square. This is one of the first floats really with the theme of New Orleans that we're starting to get. And as you can see, Shirley and Anthony Colombo do a marvelous job with these costumes. They're in Chalmette, and they've been dealing with Endymion for at least since 85. And look at the work.
They've got a whole cottage industry
Yes. They've
started there. It's incredible. And when you can look at just the elaborate detail that goes into the costumes here that Lisa Hingle is wearing and the other Rebecca Bourgeois. Do you think that's heavy? Because that just seems to me like it would be heavy.
Well, you know what? I think it's somehow they're braced in the back with something. I don't think they're having to lift that. But
I think they'd tumble over if they had to lift that.
But just the traditional gown itself probably weighs about 30 pounds, 15 at least.
And then more of our stilt walkers, these guys out of Orlando, that person is not that tall.
That's a great job, I'm telling you. All you have to do is walk and you get paid.
Yeah, but it's not the walking that's the problem, it's the falling over. Imagine walking 6 or 7 or 8 miles on those.
That would be a problem.
I'd have trouble taking 6 or 7 steps.
Looks like we've reached a little lull, but the excitement is still going on. We're going to take a break and come back with a lot more of Endymion 2003, so don't you go away.
Tuxedos provided by Cohen's Formal Wear. Quality, style, and service since 1928. Don't go away. We'll be back with Endymion 2003.
A super party in the Superdome tonight, but they're having a little fun on St. Charles Avenue, too. And Jeff Baskin is there live.
Well, John, those that have been staying here waiting for the last third of the parade to go by the House of Brawl in St. Charles are being well rewarded by plenty of throws. The crowd has thinned out considerably during the last couple hours or so, as we saw only a couple of floats within a two-hour period. But now the last few floats are moving on by. Float number 27 is just moved out in front of the House of Brawl, and float number 28 is following shortly behind. And that would be the final float for Endymion. So only one more float to go. It looks like just a little bit of a break, but not the kind of break that we saw earlier. Float number 28 looks like it's only about, oh, say 500, 1,000 feet to back on St. Charles. And then we should be wrapping things up here on St. Charles Avenue. This is the first time that Endymion has taken this route, the traditional uptown route, as it continues its way towards the Superdome. John and Nancy, how are things going on over there?
Well, they're going great, and we're looking at Casa Samba. Kind of brings Rio de Janeiro in mind.
little of the Brazilian flavor of Mardi Gras. They've got a little party down there this weekend, too.
Just a little one. Not as good as this one, though.
Well, it's actually a little violent. It's a little crazy. There are those people who go there, but you really have to be a little careful. Their party gets very out of hand. But it's a lot of samba dancing and similar, but their own sort of little flavor. Nothing quite like our party.
Yes, I think the skin showing is somewhat the same.
You think?
Yeah. I think I see another float coming in. And I believe those are the Endymion maids representing Chapa Tulis and John J. Ottoman.
All right, let's go back to Jeff Baskin for the last float at St. Charles Avenue.
Well, the last float is approaching now in front of the House of Brawl on St. Charles Avenue. We're just about wrapping it up here. The crowd has thinned out considerably. Again, the reason for that was the huge break that we saw before float 22. We saw nearly an hour break, and then after that, almost another hour before float number 23 moved on by. Now here comes the final float. It's float number 28, Cabildo to a Crawfish. This is the last of the mega floats. We got this is another two-part float here moving on by. And they're throwing. And the people that stuck it out here waiting for the last few floats, getting plenty of throws. There's just not a lot of competition anymore. It's rare to see this kind of thin crowd for Endymion. But again, it wasn't like this earlier as we saw that break, which caused a lot of people to thin out from the crowd. But again, this is the final float, and things should be moving out rather shortly as it passes on by. But the parade is still young at the Superdome, where John and Nancy are, and that's where the action's going to be for the rest of the night. John?
Okay, thanks, Jeff Baskin. Boy, I tell you, the people who hang on there at St. Charles Avenue made a haul because there was less competition.
Exactly. We're looking now at this float that I said earlier was representing Chapa Tulis. And you see the black outfits? They're representing the war shields of the Chapa Tulis tribe. And they have plumes and feathers and white mirror blue trim. Just really gorgeous, gorgeous workmanship in this stuff.
And Danielle Renee Simon, daughter of David and Lisa Simon.
And Endymion has been so responsible for the growth of Mardi Gras. You know, a typical Mardi Gras season in the mid-60s had about 20 parades, very small floats, floats that weren't much bigger than what we're seeing here with the little warm-ups. You know, they don't even give numbers to the maids' floats. We're not starting here. This isn't number three. We still have 27 huge floats to go.
It's just incredible, and people weren't coming. The hotels weren't sold out a long time ago, but once Bacchus and Endymion got rolling, what's the saying? If you build it, they will come. And they did.
And they did.
So this is the money stuff.
When you consider that hotel owners, hoteliers were kind of complaining that they had only about 90% occupancy or 95% occupancy, consider that in the 1960s, before Bacchus and before Endymion, and before marketing, I suppose, you know, hotel occupancy was maybe in the 60% range. It felt, you know, that Mardi Gras was kind of in a slump. Bacchus sort of woke things up in 69, and then Endymion came along in 74, kind of brought young people back to Mardi Gras in a way that we take for granted now.
In keeping with this New Orleans theme, this beautiful peach costume here represents the Garden District.
Another way that Endymion has changed Carnival, that kind of changed the look of Carnival, but making these magnificent, elaborate costumes that we come to take for granted almost now.
When you think about the number of members the crew has, 2,200 members or so, when you think about all those people have dues, this is a big money crew. I mean, they can afford to throw out the best throws. They can afford to be heavy-handed and show off, and that's what they're doing.
You know, I've forgotten about this. Somebody tossed me a note earlier that pointed out what Endymion's motto is, the motto of
grow till it hurts.
And I think they do a little bit of that. I don't think anybody goes home empty-handed from Endymion.
Friends
just a cross-section of people who are in this crew, cab drivers, attorneys, janitors, a U.S. senator or so. It is Mardi. It is New Orleans.
Everybody's welcome. We love that. And Nichelle Turner's on the floor.
And her on the floor where I am getting the greatest vantage point for these floats. They are absolutely amazing. When you get to see them up close and personal, it's just absolutely amazing. And right now we're going to talk a little bit here to Bill Curl, who is the mouthpiece for the Superdome. That's what I'm going to call you, the mouthpiece. You clean up good, Bill Curl. You're looking good.
What a party, huh? Are we having a ball or what?
We are having a ball. You know, have you had any sleep getting ready for this week?
Well, our crew has been working around the clock along with the Endymion people to get ready for it, and it's a big undertaking. But boy, what a result. Hey, what a time these people are having.
Anybody that's been to a Saints game knows what this dome looks like on a Sunday. And to look at it now, it's just amazing.
It's a little bit different. Ed Muniz and his crew do such a wonderful job. Been working with them for a long time, and this party, I don't know that there's a better party anywhere in the world. You know, we do Super Bowls better than anybody does. We do Final Fours better than anybody does. And look at this.
Endymion better than anybody ever could.
All right, we're doing it. We're ready.
Now, Bill, we got to be serious for just a second because I know you. There's going to be a fireworks show here around 12 o'clock tonight. You guys have been taking that extra precaution just to make sure, double check that everything's going to be safe.
All of the tests started days ago. Fire marshal was here. Building's fully up to code, and we take extra measures to make sure it's safe. Did that before the recent problem. So, you know, it's not like we changed anything. We want to be sure everybody's safe. They know when they're coming to this building, nothing to be worried about. It's going to be beautiful.
I saw the firefighters milling around, making sure, you know, just keeping an extra eye out. So that's good. Everybody in here, that's an extra added bit of relief for everybody. All the partiers in here.
That's part of the deal. That's part of the routine. And again, nobody's worried about it. Everybody's here to party and just have a good time.
Yeah, I saw you back there in that corner. You're having a good time tonight. I'm going to let you get back to party.
I have to.
All right, Bill Curl, thanks a lot. John and Nancy, I'm sending it back up to you. We've got a great band that's coming through here. These girls are so cute, and you know they're tired, but they are so cute. They're doing such a great job.
They are terrific, and earlier we saw Queen Endymion, Katie Rittner. She is a junior at Sacred Heart Academy, and this must be the biggest thrill for her to be able to be the queen of this massive, massive crew.
Yeah, this is, by the way, the Xavier University Prep marching band that you're seeing. Lane Kern taking in his work. Not quite breathing a sigh of relief yet. Got a couple of more nights. A little bit more work headed his way. And then I think after Rex rolls off successfully, I think then he kind of sighs and says, okay, and takes about a five-day break and gets ready for next year.
His son, Blaine Kern Jr., actually is responsible for, I don't know if you've seen him on television yet, but there are streamers and decorations in this dome that are breathtaking, and Blaine Kern Jr. did that.
You know, you mentioned Katie Rittner, the queen who we were seeing during the interview. She's a jock, a competitive athlete, a member of the U.S. Tennis Association, and one of the top 100, they say, top 100 tennis players in the Southeast.
Well, maybe that helps her in her throwing. Her arm is probably pretty good.
She stays connected. Well, I don't know. I didn't see her doing a lot of throwing today. You know, she might want to do throwing. I imagine there probably are some queens that get up there and say, wait a minute.
I don't want to wave. I want to throw. Right. Give me the power, I beg of you. Xavier Prep Band is fabulous. They're another one of those traditional New Orleans bands that you can't get enough of. Dedicated.
They're good.
They are excellent. And they still have pep in their step, which is amazing.
That they do. Somehow.
We're talking about Blaine Kern as we watch the next float come through. 40 Mardi Gras parades every year, all over at least the Gulf South. And he just gets better and better. I mean, it's amazing.
And there is, you know, the difference between Bacchus and Endymion is that the celebrity king rules over Bacchus, but technically here is our king, King Endymion the 37th, Patrick Nunez of Harvey, a retired first aid and CPR instructor with the Texaco Corporation. And the way they're very democratic here in Endymion, the way that they pick their king is basically by lottery, right? They do a drawing.
They pull a name, and whoever gets it, gets it.
Whoever pulls it has a coronary for the 20 grand he'll spend on parties and whatnot.
Exactly. I tell you what, he's only been in Endymion, Mr. Nunez, since 2000. He said when they pulled his name, his knees got weak, and he wanted to faint. But he looks pretty good. I mean, I think he's holding up.
He's doing okay. They have renovated this float tonight. You can see the fiber optics. It's unbelievable the thousands and thousands of miles of fiber optics that they've put together. These multicolor endpoint fiber optic lightings at the front and back that have jazzed up the Kings float, and we'll see more of that sort of thing to represent a flame. We'll see more of this really elaborate lighting as the night goes on. We have much more to come, so stay with us. More of Endymion 2003 on Fox 8 in a moment.
At the Papa Joe SS Endymion, the first super float ever in Endymion, and boy, have they come a long way. But this float is 57 feet long with 60 riders, and it's named after Papa Joe Munez and Papa Joe Asunto, the guardian angels of Endymion.
And you see more of that fiber optic lighting we were talking about. They've got new smokestacks. They've outfitted totally refitted it, if you will.
It has a searchlight on the front, John. And the searchlight, I guess, I don't know if this is it or not, but the searchlight is simply because they've never done the uptown route before, and they needed to guide and navigate their way through.
Do you believe that?
That's what they say.
That's what they say, all
and
right.
And you know what, the only time that the Papa Joe had to roll in Kenner in 1979 during that police strike. So on the wheel, a little bit of trivia, on the paddle wheel, they have three dates. They have 1979 Kenner, they have 2003 Uptown, and then they have, of course, the original date that Endymion began, the Mid-City Route.
Yeah, commissioned, I think.
Yes.
This was a big deal back in 1976 when they debuted this. I mean, just the thought of having that many riders on one float at the time was mind-boggling. And of course, we've more than doubled it now.
Right. Traditionally, just for your information, about 20 riders are on a regular float. But this is like nothing we've ever seen.
They put almost 20 riders on a maid's float, it seems. Not quite, but it seems like it.
Archbishop Shaw High School.
Look at the hands in the air. And I think they're living up to the motto,
wow,
of throw till it hurts.
I think we need to get into the action. Sheriff Harry Lee's on the floor. I wonder if he's catching anything. The Shell Turner's talking to him.
That's right. I am here with Harry Lee. Sheriff, you look good.
I feel good. I'm very relaxed. Everybody's standing. I'm sitting.
You told me all you had was Diet Coke in that cup. Am I supposed to believe?
Diet Coke. And you smelled it.
I did smell it. Sheriff, you know what? This Endymion should be special for you. You're about to undergo something big.
Oh, no. This is a great parade, I saw. I didn't what you said earlier.
I said, so you're about to go and have gastric bypass surgery. How you feeling?
Well, I feel great. I'm looking forward to it. Like a big honey trip or a Super Bowl or something.
Yeah, I called you earlier this week, and you said, I got to call you back. I'm in getting some tests.
That's where I was. When you called me, I was in the operating room.
That was crazy. Why were you answering the phone? That's what I wanted to know.
I was meeting the anesthesiologist in the operating room when you called.
Do you have a favorite float during this whole thing?
No, they all. or blank current floats. They do a great job with this parade. Everybody's having a good time.
And how's everything been going over in Jefferson Parish? How's everything been going over in Jefferson Parish?
Everything going fine. Everything going good.
All right, successful Mardi Gras 2003. Oh, he's shooing me away. You want me to leave? All right, that's Sheriff Harry Lee. He's having a good time. He told me to get out of here so he can just have fun tonight. How about that? Back to you guys.
All right, he wants you to leave because you're infringing on his territory.
He says, take a hike. Take a hike.
He wants to catch some throws.
That's right. Now, I think on this Papa Joe SS Endymion, smoke actually comes out of these stacks, too. But this is nothing like the Captain Eddie SS Endymion.
This confetti has been falling from above, and that's really one of the few times today we've managed to get a shot of it. I don't know how much, I don't know how many trees they unloaded.
Sort of like a ticker tape parade.
Yeah, it is at times. And it's been falling like that throughout the time we've been on the air. I think in this case, it's coming out of the float itself. I don't know what they're doing there, but they're... They've got something going on with the crowd and the guys on the float.
I don't see many beads coming out. I think they're being stingy. When they get around here to us, we're going to go crazy. We're going to make them throw something.
They get stingy, you think, when they get around to us?
Yeah.
All right. I don't know how stingy Joe Trahan thinks they are, but let's find out.
All right, guys, thanks so much. We're here, and we're getting pelted with beads. I'm with Tulane head football coach Chris Selfo. Chris, I know you really enjoy this. You're from around these parts. Talk about what this Endymion means to you, besides getting pelted by these beads.
Well, I'm watching myself right now, Joe, and I can tell you this. This is a great event. Ed Munez does a tremendous service to our community. It really is a great parade and great people involved in it, and it's wonderful for my wife and I to come out here and do this.
Let's talk a little bit about your Tulane football team. You guys, with an incredible win over Hawaii, really set the tone for next season. Talk about your prospects for the coming year.
Well, Joe, the big thing is we've got to replace some good players. That bowl game win was big for our program, great for the city. I think everyone watched it on national TV, and I think it's something that our kids can build on, know what it takes to get there, and that's the big thing.
You're used to seeing touchdown passes and big runs in this building. How incredible is it from your perspective to see this wonderful spectacle here tonight?
Joe, my wife and I walked upstairs to the second level and looked at it tonight, and it's wonderful. I wish we can, you know, my dream is to get this dome acting like this on a Saturday game for Tulane.
All right, you got it. Thanks so much, Chris Selfo. John Nancy, back to you.
All right, thanks, Joe. You know, it's you could never adequately explain to anyone this party. There would you could do it in a book or an encyclopedia and never really totally capture everything about it. And I think it's kind of a shame that although Mardi Gras is so much bigger in Bourbon Street or on Bourbon Street than it ever was before, people around the country don't have this image, which to locals is really what Mardi Gras is about.
It's amazing. I tell you what, the Papa Joe SS Endymion is right behind us, and I think that's what you're probably hearing.
I don't know if they're hearing it at home or not. It's certainly what we're hearing, no question
it's
about
loud.
It. What are you going to do at K&B? Schwegman's gone away.
Right.
Schwegman's gone away, ain't there no more, is what
right.
They're saying.
Well, this is it. This is all about paying tribute to what ain't there no more.
There's a lot there, unfortunately.
Oh, man, too much. But this is great. This is a theme that I'm surprised they didn't come up with it earlier. It's so perfect.
Yeah, it really is a great theme. And again, if you're just joining us, our live coverage of Endymion 2003 on Fox 8 to the theme tonight of New Orleans A to Z, everything from the Audubon Zoo to Zulu.
Everything from Pontchartrain Park.
Lincoln Beach, a couple of things
that's
that
right.
Aren't there either.
All right, Claudia Coffey has Pete Fountain. Let's toss to her.
I so lucked out. I ran into Pete Fountain up here. We are so excited. Pete Fountain, Grand Marshal, New Orleans legend. What else do we say?
Oh, it's been a good day, a good ride. So everybody had a good time. I had a good time.
Now, how many times have you done this? Now, come on.
With this organization, it's the second time. But I have my half-fast walking club, which is 43 years we've been doing it.
You never get tired of Mardi Gras, do you?
No, that's part of me. Really, it's a big part of me.
So many people today, we heard everybody talking. They're so happy to see you in parade after parade. They love seeing you.
Well, I enjoy it. That's what it's all about, to enjoy it.
You got to show off your fabulous Grand Marshal pin here. I don't know, camera's kind of a little bit far away, but this is the shiniest. Oh, wow. I don't think many people get something that nice.
Not too many. I'm really proud of it.
Do you have anything to say to John and Nancy upstairs that are working really, really hard tonight?
Oh, keep it up. It's great people. No, they put all of this stuff together. That's fantastic.
Well, very, very good. So nice to see you. Thanks so much for being here.
Have a good one.
Pete Fountain. Wow. All right, back to you guys.
All right, thanks, Claudia. Pete Fountain just told us to keep it up, meaning work hard.
Yeah, well, I guess we better.
I suppose. That is float number two, if you can consider that, of 27. So we're really only up to the second float. Endymion welcomes you to the Mardi Gras. This is the one with 100 riders and the Baton Rouge contingent. Everybody on there from the Baton Rouge area.
This is a huge float and gorgeous. And when we come back, we're going to take a closer look at it. We'll have much more of Endymion 2003 in just a moment.
Tuxedos provided by Cohen's Formal Wear. Quality, style, and service since 1928. Don't go away. We'll be back with Endymion 2003.
And we're back in the Superdome for Endymion 2003. And absolutely nothing has happened. So many times, I mean that in the way that so many times what happens is we'll find one of the great floats. We'll take a commercial break. By the time we come back, it's run through. In this case, you can see there up in the right-hand corner of your screen, that is Endymion welcomes you to the Mardi Gras, the float we were showing you with its one, if you can imagine this, its 1.2 million feet of endpoint fiber optic lighting.
And if you can imagine this, it's 120 feet long, almost half the size of the SSD.
Yeah, had another one of these also animated floats, the first very animated float that we've seen, and they've lit it up with the lights. The Jester really has become one of the classics.
Yeah.
Although they don't change it from year to year, it got a facelift a couple of years ago. To modernize it.
And this is really showing the old New Orleans and the new New Orleans. So they have everything on here from a new city skyline to a Superdome to the old town. It's just really an amazing piece of work.
Sometimes these parades will go by and you can see there the French Quarter design that Nancy was talking about, kind of the soft pastel colors. You go to a parade, you get so worked up about catching something. Catching that really important throw or those great beads that you forget to look at the floats, although it's a little hard to miss that with Endymion because they are so spectacular, and I think the lighting has a lot to do with that too. But the forward one here, because this is one of those tandem floats, depicts the French Quarter, the old city, the soft colors, and then when we get to the second float, it's kind of splashed with bright colors for the feel of the vibrant, progressive city of the 21st century.
And really, this fiber optic lighting that we keep talking about is done by a company in Kenner. So we're always keeping it close to home, and they do a fantastic job. I think it's Imagination Illuminations. I think I may have said it wrong, but it's a company in Kenner. They do fantastic job with this fiber optic lighting. You see the way Endymion changes. The word Endymion changes.
Yeah, so important, because until they came up with the fiber optics, you could light floats with little light bulbs, but you didn't get, you know, that splash, that brightness.
In a moment,
that's
you'll be able
amazing.
To see. It is. It actually has the Louisiana Superdome
on the very tail end of the float and Harrah's Casino.
So when it comes around, you'll be able to see the shape of the dome done in lights. This float is probably one of the pricier ones. There are some floats that are upwards of $120,000, $130,000 just to build.
And there's the Superdome that you were talking about.
Pretty good replica, actually.
And on this set of float, we welcome
some of these guys get into the Superdome and they realize they're just about out of everything. Others get here and look down and realize, oh, I've got to get rid of this stuff.
Right.
Look at this guy, the guy that they the one actually to the left of him. Well, he's just tossing it out there, but there was the other guy had a whole bag yet, like a Santa's bag of throws yet to get rid of. And he's running out of time.
But people are not running out of patience. Look at that. Some guy threw a big bag.
Right, and think that's the dignitaries table. Think of that. There's no other event in the world where the dignitaries, the little VIP section, behave like children. And it's perfectly acceptable. In fact, it's unacceptable not to.
I want to be a dignitary. I want to be.
You know, as I look at the crowd, John,
you can dress as a dignitary on Tuesday.
All right, great. It really does look a little thinner than last year now that I'm looking out. It's not quite as packed, but it's still pretty exciting.
It's still in the neighborhood of 12,000 people or so.
You see the high-rise buildings here on the side. And then again, the dome. Okay, they're coming to us. I'm going to try to get something.
I think with that big, strong voice of yours tonight, you need to, you know, scream, throw me something, mister. I'm sure you can get their attention.
Oh, okay, I got something. Okay, I got cups.
Whoa, you did.
Okay, wait. Woo! I got pearls.
So if you put some work into it, it can make it can
Knock
help.
My head off. Wait.
I didn't know I was going to get caught in the line of fire here.
I got these.
We may have to stand up and defend ourselves or go down to Miss Mimi and get in her plexiglass, you know? Claudia Coffee is down there where the action is. Claudia?
It's dangerous, actually. I found George Rodriguez, a blue dog fame. How are you doing?
It's wonderful. Having a great time.
People see you and your wife, Wendy, and they just slam you guys to speed.
Dangerous up here.
What happened to you last year? Apparently you had quite a few injuries.
The first beat hit me right across my nose, and blood just came on all night.
What's next? Where are we going to see Blue Dog next? I mean, how do you keep where? Blue Dog where? Blue Dog where? Blue Dog with Aaron Carter where?
We're going to see Blue Dog in the August parade, Mardi Gras Day. I'm throwing 200,000 Blue Dog doubloons. Three gold ones, and if you get a gold one, you get a $5,000 print.
Wait a minute. I hope everybody heard that over all the noise. That is great.
Yeah, it's at Metairie, the Metairie parade in August.
Now, how many years have you been coming to this?
This is our 10th year, but I was Grand Marshal August last year. I'm just a guest.
Is it just as exciting when you're just a guest?
Oh, absolutely. This is the best Mardi Gras I ever had. I'm made in Mid-City this year. You and my friend Margo's queen have had a ball. Really fun.
I've been watching you guys walking back and forth, and you all have been partying up here. You've been having a great time.
We have. We brought a lot of guests from out of town, too. A bunch of people from California and New York. They're having a ball. They're all out here catching bees.
Well, you all have a lovely, lovely night. Good to talk to both.
Thank you.
George Rodriguez and Wendy Rodriguez. Let's send it back up to you guys.
Okay, thanks, Claudia. We have stood up here, and I think we did it in a self-defense move, except that I'm wired in with all these wires they have us connected to. So I think all that's really happened is I've just become a target.
Right. I feel like dancing with them. Look, they're great.
They're good, the Smiley High School Band. More tributes to New Orleans coming your way when we come back with more of Endymion 2003.
Welcome back to Endymion 2003, live on Fox 8. Here's John Snell and Nancy Parker.
We are in the Superdome in the middle of chaos, but it's great chaos. We're looking at another gorgeous float come in. This one is the S float. No, the New Orleans A to Z float, actually. This is the tidal float.
You know, it's loud in here. It is chaos, but it's a sort of organized chaos. And the amazing thing is we pull this off every year without any one entity being in charge of Mardi Gras, because, you know, we get questions from reporters from other cities or national media outlets who will come in and say, hey, you know, okay, who's in charge of Mardi Gras? Because the thought is that we do have a coordinating committee, but if you were going to throw a party like this, obviously there would be a committee or there'd be one person in charge, and it's not. It just sort of happens. If they tried to outlaw it, it would happen.
This tidal float, New Orleans A to Z, is a three-unit float, more than a million feet of endpoint fiber optic lighting. And this float made its debut in the year 2000. It's 114 feet long. And here's the funny part. It has huge mass of the Greek muses, Melpomene, which we say Melpomene in New Orleans, and Thalia, which we say Thalia. We don't, you know, we always say things differently here. So,
They give it in the little guide, they give you the little pronunciation,
right.
And the crew of Endymion gives it to you in the way it's supposed to be done.
Right. But we don't say Melpomene around here, it's Melpomene. Got it? Good.
Ladies and gentlemen,
got it, Thalia.
But you know what? This float can light up an entire city block.
That's how bright it is.
It can light up some faces. We know that.
Now we're going to get pelted in probably the next 3 minutes. So I'm just warning you.
As I said, I think we have made ourselves targets. They have these the giant scroll there in the center of the float, and then there's a central staircase for the riders that starts behind each of the masks, you see, because they've got to have a way to get up there on the second floor of this thing. If people 30 and 40 years ago could have seen what this would become, because it's taken, you know, one step at a time.
Okay.
Mind-boggling. You ready?
Time to stop talking and start catching, baby. Let's roll.
It's time to start defending.
All right.
You know, almost.
This is the way to do it. I'm not even having to yell. See, you just kind of hold your hands out. Whoa, see? There you go.
Let me get another one for you.
Tracy, have a good time.
Okay, they're embarrassing me now.
What, you expect them to spot you among 12,000 people? Here I am.
It used to work maybe when I was younger.
The chute, float number four.
Let's go downstairs to Joe Trahan.
Thanks so much, John. We're here with a priest who is enjoying himself. Father, tell us your name and what parish you're from.
Father Rene Cervantes, Arley at the Lake in Mandeville. Is that John Snell?
John Snell did just throw to me.
I know. Hey, John, it's Father Rene. Remember me.
Great. You remember him, John. Tell us about the fun that you're having, and will you do a dispensation at any point of the night, Father?
We had mass before the parade this morning, so everything's all right. Everything's good.
All right, great. And I understand there's also a tie-in between yourself and Bob Breck. Tell us what that tie is, Father.
It's a secret right now, but we'll find out in April.
All right, great. That has something to do with Mr. Breck and some impending nuptials. But anyway, Father, when you see everyone getting together like this and the people who are having good, clean fun, what does it make you think about, and how does it make you feel as a man of the cloth?
This is what it's all about. Giving joy to everyone, giving peace to everyone. This is what it's all about. This is what brings New Orleans together.
Great. Well, I'm kind of saying this tongue-in-cheek. I used to be an altar boy. I grew up Catholic. Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. John, Nancy, back to you.
I think there's got to be a little more sincerity to that request. Hello, Father Rene.
Well, you know what? This is the Irish and Italians ironworks float. Is that right?
It is. I was trying to find the number, and then logic dictated I just look at the float.
So it was very fitting, wasn't it?
Top of the morning to you. A float that kind of salutes the party spirit.
It does.
Mardi Gras.
It's really rooted in the city's Roman Catholic heritage, public celebration of the feast days, embraced by just about everyone who enjoys parades and parties, so you don't have to really be Catholic to enjoy it.
Kind of does. Kind of a little salute, you know, to St. Paddy's and St. Joseph's, those feasts that are celebrated with great enthusiasm, not too far after, not too long from now, come to think of it.
Right. So we've reached a sort of lull. I guess this is what Jeff was talking about, the big gap in parade, because that door over there looks dark, and that's scary.
That is a little scary, because your voice is not that strong. There were a couple of gaps throughout the night, a couple of times when it got maybe to be about 20 minutes or 30 minutes before another float came along. And, you know, fortunately, they're not going to stick to this route. They'll go back to the route that they built the cruise for. But a little bit of an issue here. Nobody really knew how this would go off tonight. And certainly everybody here in the Dome has had a great time. But on the parade route, we understand that there were those people who, during the course of the evening, just kind of gave up.
But to be realistic about it, when you have to move stoplights to get a parade through the streets, I mean, you know that you're going to have some logistical problems.
Right, and they knew that they were going to have a problem with especially the big, huge 200-rider float, the SS Endymion. They knew that it was going to be an issue because the thing is, you know, it's like three different sections, and they were not going to take it apart. They were going to leave it up to the driver. I guess you have to just put your best tractor driver on it and hope he can pull it off.
Okay, we got another float coming.
I think they're working it.
Yeah, I think that's what you call that. Good job, John. Good job. Spotting it. Okay, let's go. Woo! Awesome.
You know, I think your voice is coming back.
Maybe it is.
I'm noticing just a little more fervor.
I was trying to do a Lauren Bacall thing, but it's not working.
I think that we may be okay. It may not be that there's a lull. It may be that they've got to get some of these big, huge floats out of here. So hopefully we don't have a lull. Hopefully we just have kind of the regular pause that we normally would get, because it takes a while to get these, you know, 114-foot long floats out of the Dome. Eventually they start stacking them up, but they're not able to do that this early in the parade. They would need a room. This is the world's largest room, and they would need something probably twice as large in order to get all these floats in here. And I don't think the city will spend $700 million just, you know.
You don't think?
I don't think so. Maybe not. It's possible, I suppose.
They tried. A couple of people tried to get it done, but it didn't happen.
Thank you.
All right, as these go, let others come. I see another one entering the dome, I believe, right now. This is the...
All right, well, we wait for the next float to make its way into the Superdome. Claudia Coffey is with Tim Coulon.
Tim Coulon, who is Parish president, of course, of Jefferson Parish, but tonight he's kind of being a bartender serving drinks up here. You look like you're having a wonderful time tonight.
Well, it's a great night. It's a great example of what Mardi Gras, pulling thousands of people together and having a party at the same time.
Now, of course, you're going to be retiring, what, the end of the year?
Yes.
That's correct. My term comes to a conclusion at the end of, actually, January of 2004.
Now, come on. Are you really going to take it easy and stay at home? Or are you going to be one of those very, very active people we're not going to ever see leave the spotlight?
Well, I plan to be very active. In fact, just another career change for me. I've had 27 years of government work, and it's been great. The people have been great to me, and I'd like to do something else. I'm looking for a job, in fact.
Do you hear that? Johnny might be looking out for your job, huh? Maybe so, maybe a little TV work?
I couldn't handle that one. Not that good.
Well, it's wonderful to see you, and best of luck to you. And you know what, I have a feeling you will find a job.
Well, I hope so. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Let's send it back up to you guys.
All right, thanks so much, Claudia. This is float number 5, the S float. And you may have noticed as we go from A to Z, New Orleans A to Z, that we're not going in alphabetical order. We're jumping all over the alphabet. This is the one that salutes everything from the Saints to the Superdome.
Right.
And we see another one. They're really rolling them in, one right after the other. That looks like the red beans to Romanoff right after it.
That one makes me hungry.
The Romanoff? Oh, the
red
beans.
Ah,
oh, okay.
The Romanoff.
We're back to everything. Everything I on the Irish, or I'm sorry, the Saints. Everything S. Everything on there from Humpty Dumpty to Storyland in New Orleans. If you look closely at this float, you see Humpty Dumpty is on there.
Old King Cole.
Kind of a salute to Storyland. There's a streetcar, and then behind the streetcar on the first float coming in is a swamp at dawn, a St. Charles Avenue mansion. The second unit depicts the Saints, which we saw, the Sugar Bowl, St. Louis Cathedral, and as it comes around, you'll see maybe a Six Flags.
Yes.
And a little tribute to Six Flags, one of the newer attractions
Everything
of Mardi Gras.
S. So we have to think of an S word to say we're going to a break. See you later.
See you soon. Like in 2 minutes. We'll be right back.
Now, back with more of Endymion 2003 on Fox 8, live tonight from the Louisiana Superdome. Here's John Snell and Nancy Parker.
We're back to our Red Beans to Romanoff is the float. If you're wondering how we got here, the legend is that Rex, the King of Carnival, was formed in honor of the Grand Duke Alexis Romanoff, as seen on the side of the float that just passed there. The Rex organization honored his visit to the city in 1872.
And he was smitten with an actress in New Orleans, and the song If Ever I Cease to Love came from that. I think she sang that song on stage. Rice is grown in Louisiana. It's a staple starch.
And what you see there is the M float. That's Mardi Gras. You may have noticed the muffalata there at the beginning of the float, that spicy concoction of salami and cheese and olive salad.
You have to get it from Central Grocery one time, at least if you're in New Orleans. Someone just caught me a teddy bear.
We're going to let you listen in to the band that is playing here. They keep talking about how they're adding something every year to Carnival and to Endymion especially. Believe it or not, they've added a stage band this year because the parade's not enough. So listen in to what the crowd is hearing here in the dome.
One more time, y'all. J-O. Ain't I call them you wanna go? Come on, raise your hands up with us. Ole, 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 ole. Ole, 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 ole.
I love it here.
You're suggesting that nothing like this is happening in Cleveland tonight?
No.
New Orleans is the unique American place. It just is.
That muffalata really is looking good.
I know, I'm getting hungry.
I know.
I need to take a little trip down to Central Grocery tomorrow.
Oh, and it's got crawfish, too. Look at the bottom.
Look at the hands. Look at the hundreds of arms and hands stretching into the air.
They want these cheap beads. They've got to have them. They should just throw money. That would be great.
Little frisbee there.
Okay, here are some beads. I'm going to get some for us. Yeah. Ooh, there you go. Whole handful.
And they're just pouring in one right after the other. There are, let me see, 6 huge 100 or so foot floats in this building at the same time, either coming into it or going out of it.
The lull is gone.
Well, I think what happens over a period of time is sometimes when they get a lull, the tractor driver will just step on it and try to catch up with the rest of the crew.
Let's go to Joe Trahan on the floor.
Thanks so much, you guys. We've got some interesting throws this year, some things we haven't seen. That's a basketball, you guys, with kind of a Mardi Gras, demonic, alien-looking court jester sort of thing. Haven't seen basketballs thrown before. That's a true sign that the NBA is here, hopefully to stay. I also saw these, you guys. Yeah, sportsman's paradise. We've got fishing lures that are being thrown. That's looking like some kind of sparkle beetle there. Nice little lure there. I think I'm going to give those to Andrew Lucas. He's our reporter who loves fishing. A lot of interesting throws this year. Back to you guys.
Well, there's a practicality to the throws now. Just play a little basketball, go fishing.
You can actually use this stuff.
You know, in Mobile, they throw moon pies.
Really?
Moon pies.
Yeah, I thought they threw them here, too. Aaron Carter again, the heartthrob. I feel like I should scream or something. Or maybe I shouldn't. Not with this voice.
Oh, go ahead. Oh, go ahead.
Aaron. There's so many themes to the floats, but you know what? It's so exciting. Nobody cares. Michelle Turner's on the floor.
Hey, guys, how you doing? You know what? We're just in the thick of things right now. Hey, throw me something! Throw me something! All right! This is what you do here. Now, their motto is throw till it hurts here in Endymion. And let me tell you, it's time to stop, because it hurts. I've been getting pounded all night. Look, I've got a haul, and I've got some great beads. These are like Endymion signature beads that light up. They're great. They're really neat. And I also caught some cups. So they've got some great throws. They've got doubloons. They're throwing just about everything. You know, the big prize, though, are those really big beads. Those things hurt, though, when you're not looking and they throw them at you. I'm, like, right in the middle of where they're throwing. So whenever they come, the floats come around the bend, everything comes right here to me. So if you guys need anything tonight, I'm the one to ask for, because I got all the good blows here. Back up to you guys.
You know, I got one of those lures I just noticed.
Really?
Here. It's, by the way, Nichelle, it's throw till it hurts the rider, not the parade goer.
I got a teddy bear. This is really cool.
Teddy bears and basketballs and light up beads.
I just got clocked in the face.
Wow.
With a bead. I think my teeth are out. I really do.
Oh, well, that'll add greatly to the night's experience.
Am I bleeding?
So far as we know, no blood drawn on the parade route tonight. But we're not done yet, and we have more of Endymion 2003 coming up on Fox 8.
We are back. Endymion 2003, and this is what it's all about. This is what we've been waiting for. You're looking at the K-Flow. Did you see that big Mardi Gras baby?
If that was the baby for a king cake, that would be one big king cake.
Yeah, you're going to owe somebody a king cake for the rest of your life, that's for sure.
I remember that somebody at the Times Speaking Union did a story maybe 15 or 20 years ago, and they talked to the factory that makes the king cake, and they had a great quote from one of the ladies. She said, or makes the little babies. She said, you do what with them? I don't know what other market there is for those little plastic babies, but apparently somewhere somebody else buys those.
Right.
And the worker at the factory somewhere in the Northeast had no idea what they get used for.
Let's go to Claudia Coffee right now.
I'm seriously, really jamming with Jerry Romick, voice of the Saints. How you doing, Jerry?
I'm doing fine. First down, Saints.
I didn't even have to ask him to do it. Yeah, but didn't you want to say a few other choice words for the Saints this season, though, that you really couldn't?
Oh, no. How do you like our party for a few intimate friends?
This is a nice little party you're having.
Just a few intimate friends, that's all. We just call together the relations.
I do have to say, though, I think you have the loudest seats any place in the building. You are right by and literally on top of the speaker.
It's like being at a rap convention.
Because we really know you're kind of a rock and roll kind of, you're a dancing machine, aren't you?
Oh, no. Yeah, I don't think my wife would agree with that, no.
She looks like she's a bit annoyed by now with all this bass.
I think she's just about had it. We're waiting for our son to pass. He's on float 17.
Oh, that's going to be a wonderful time. Do you ever get tired of coming to this? Or is it just
new and
different and unique every year because of the theme?
Not really. Be a part of Endymion all these years has been a great opportunity. I mean, I've watched this crew grow from a neighborhood parade when the first year they rented floats. From the crew of Carrollton, they rented costumes. And the young man, Eddie Muniz, just took it, and he just grew and grew, and today it is the crew in New Orleans. There's no doubt about it. This parade is absolutely super.
Now, do you think they'll stay on the St. Charles route or move back to Mid-City?
Oh, I know. I know that they hope they can get back to Carrollton Avenue to Orleans tomorrow. They'd love it there. They have a great concert every year that they call the Mardi Gras that lasts all Saturday afternoon. The people love it. I knew of one family literally bought a house on Orleans to be near Endymion.
I believe it.
They felt really at home on Orleans by City Park, and I know they're anxious to get back.
Well, it is so nice to see you. Have a wonderful Mardi Gras. Yeah. Back to you, John and Nancy.
Okay, thanks, Claudia. That was Jean Lafitte, who you saw during the course of the interview, of course, the romanticized figure of the Buccaneer standing above the Gulf, the rolling waves of Float L Lafitte to LSU. And there he is back in our picture again there now.
And Marie Laveau is on that float as well. And this song they're about to play is It's Getting Hot in Here. And that's true. It's getting hot in here.
Well, let's listen in. This is the end float, Negan to Nutria, and that was a larger-than-life figure of Aaron Neville gracing the front of that float.
And Ray Negan is supposed to be on here as well. I'm looking for him. Where's the mayor?
I don't know, but I think Aaron Carter's getting into it.
Oh, there he is on the end. Look.
You may recognize Senator John Breaux there, the only United States senator dressed in this kind of, the only United States senator tonight wearing beads, I assure you.
I think you're right.
Joe Trahan's down in the middle of all this mayhem. Joe? All right, we are experiencing, as they say in the business, technical difficulties, so we'll get back to Joe in just a minute.
Nelly's music just cuts everybody off.
The L float, Lafitte to LSU.
As we look at the big golden boys go down the stretch, we're going to take a break. Mardi Gras in 2003, Endymion 2003.
Mic check, 1-2.
In a moment.
Tuxedos provided by Cohen's Formal Wear. Quality, style, and service since 1928. Don't go away. We'll be back with Endymion 2003.
Fox 8 coverage of Endymion 2003 has been brought to you in part by Antoine's Famous Cakes and Pastries.
It is a battle of beads in the Superdome. This is so exciting. I wish you were here.
It's a battle of beads, and the beads are winning. We have just a couple minutes left in our broadcast, unfortunately. I think the party will go on for, I think it's safe to say, maybe a good 5.5 hours. But we're going to wrap things up here and kind of go around our little home here in the Dome one more time, beginning with Joe Trahan and Claudia Coffey.
Thanks so much. As the parade gets really wound up, we're doing the same here. And there's some folks who are waiting for the post-parade entertainment. You guys looking forward to Cool in the Gang?
Man, we're waiting on Cool in the Gang. I want some of that old school funk. I want to hear some of that Can't Get Enough of That Funky Stuff, Hollywood Swingers.
These are the Wibbles, and you guys are down, man.
Really, we got to have a ball. This is New Orleans, the best yet.
All right, great. They're ready to celebrate good times. Come on. And they made it.
Thank you so much. They've been practicing what they're going to say.
That's right. Hey, Michelle, what you got going on over there?
Woo! It's getting hot in here tonight.
night. This has been so much fun. I just caught a red, white, and blue football. I'm doing good. I've got a haul here. I am rocking and rolling, and so is the crowd. You guys, this is such a fun time. It's my first Endymion ball, so I've just been enjoying it like everybody else. The Top Cats are rolling, and everybody here is just, you know what, happy. That's a good thing. John and Nancy, did you guys have a good time tonight?
Oh, did we ever. Look, I got so much stuff, I'm not going to put it all on. It's crazy. Crazy.
Well, I think there would be a neck injury if you put it all on. 12,000 happy people here in the Superdome tonight. It's I think people need a break from all the day's news, from the countless stories about, you know, terrorism threats or whatever else. And New Orleans needed a diversion, and those thousands of people from around the country who joined us for our little party among intimate friends, as Jerry Romig said, kind of needed a diversion. 2,200 people will ride in this parade tonight, and another 10 or 12,000 or so will join them in the Superdome, and they will party on, even though we have to leave you, they will party on through the night until the music stops, so maybe four or five hours from now.
This is a city that care forget your cares. Good night, everybody.